Welcome back to Faith on Wheels. Today we have another review of the Volvo XC40, which is the compact SUV of Volvo. It's nighttime and we're at a different location. Well, without further ado, let's go for a drive. I have driven this car for around 10 days now, so I've learned quite a lot of things about it. And in this review, I will share my thoughts about the Volvo XC40. In the compact SUV market, the XC40 competes with Mercedes GLE, BMW X1, the Audi Q3, cars of that size. And to be honest, the Volvo XC40 feels just a tiny bit bigger than those cars. The XC40 is mainly based on comfort, and you feel that in every way. The suspension soaks up road imperfections quite okay. It's of course not very floaty, but the damping is quite comfortable. You have the button here for driving modes. You have four different driving modes. You have comfort, which is the main and default setting. You also have dynamic, which is for a little bit more sporty driving. And you have eco and off-road. The steering is very light in comfort, also light in dynamic. But what happens in dynamic mode is that mid-corner and on higher speeds, the steering weight adds up, and by doing so the center feel is much more noticeable and the steering becomes a lot better. Still not, of course, not as good as in a sports car, but very good for the type of car it is. Let's give it full throttle from launch in comfort mode. Definitely hear that it's a three-cylinder engine. It doesn't sound very refined, but what it is with Volvos, you also hear a turbo whistle. That's that's the case in most Volvos, I've noticed. The transmission is an 8-speed automatic. In comfort, it does respond quite slow, but when you put the car into the dynamic mode, it's surprisingly quick. Also, when you put it into manual mode, it also responds quite fast. And Volvo wouldn't be Volvo if they hadn't got their safety features. They have a ton of safety features here. You can control them, you can access them by going through this infotainment screen, which is completely touchscreen. The climate controls are also touchscreen. If we swipe to the left side of the menu, you see the safety features. We have lane keeping assist, anti-collision assist, blind spot assist, and much more safety features. The touchscreen, this display reacts quite fast to the touchscreens. But sometimes, if you want to go back just one menu, it's hard to access that and you have to press this home button to go back completely and do it all over again. That can be quite annoying sometimes. The competitors do a much better job, in my opinion. And this instrument cluster, the graphics looks very good, but it isn't changeable. This instrument cluster is fixed. It's fixed. It's a fixed display. You can have the navigation here in the middle, but you can't change the dials, which is a bit of a shame. For example, Audi and Mercedes do a much better job with changing the instrument cluster. The materials in the interior feel also quite good. In the low end, you feel a little bit of cheaper plastics, but on the top end you feel nice soft touch materials. The seats in the XC40 are quite comfortable. They also feel very nice. The leather quality is very good.
Fuel economy in the XC40 is, with my driving style, 8 to 8.5 liters per 100 kilometers, which isn't that good for a 3-cylinder petrol engine, but it's a heavier car and it has all-wheel drive. And if you drive the car more slow, you should be able to get a lot more. The fuel capacity is 54 liters. So if you push the car a lot, you will find yourself doing quite a lot of fuel stops.
So what's my verdict on the Volvo XC40? Overall, it's a pretty good looking car. Interior also feels good. The engine in the T3, it's quite decent for a 3-cylinder engine. It's definitely not a dynamic car, but it's pretty comfortable. It's also very practical. You have some nice options and safety features. Transmission responsiveness could be a bit better. If you're looking for a compact SUV, which is based on comfortable driving, you should definitely consider the XC40. Put it in dynamic mode and give it some power.